Well, hello everyone, it's me, Daniel, with 47 website designs. Is that the name of my website? I can't remember. Yeah, 47 website designs. I'm trying to get out of saying website candy. Today, I'm in Photoshop and I am resizing some images for a client. They're still in the process of launching their website. We are on the cuff. We are almost to the end. And what I wanted to share with you guys was today is, as I'm resizing these images here, you want to be very intentional when it comes to your file extension that you name. So if you're building websites for people, or if you're getting a website built, do not let anyone just send you these images and say, hey, here you go. You want to give them unique names. As you can see here, I've just been kind of goofing off a little bit, but basically what you want to do is you want to be descriptive as possible to say blue underscore. Always use underscores and always use lowercase letters in reference to the spaces in the words there. So I'm gonna say blue flower underscore dress. Okay, so you know what happens is when you actually take this image right here to the web, and you go to the website, people can actually find you, or you can get a search. You can get a hit off the website based on the image in the website. Over here, I actually Googled green dresses. You know what I'm saying? I can say, I don't know much about dresses, so I can say green maxi dress. And what's going to happen here is over here, ladies, you guys have to let me know if this is a maxi dress, but you see all these different green maxi dresses. Here's a brown dress right here, and I'm gonna drag this to my desktop. And what I want to do is I want to try to see the extension on this actual dress right here. So no, don't email anything. That's not what I was trying to do. Okay. All right, let's go over here. Oh, stop it. And I want to go command I, and it says olive green. So that's why it came up is in the green there, because it's an olive green dress versus a actual just a regular green dress. That didn't look olive to me. But basically, there's a description right there. But what I'm trying to get at here is if you name your images and you're intentional about the images that you name with your file extensions that's going up to your website, this potentially you can get actually a hit off of a website. So this dress right here, and here I am on this misguided website, and it looks like this dress is not even available, but it could potentially lead to some type of sale, some type of, you know, this may become some lady's favorite website where she does all her shopping going forward just because of what she found over here in Google. So once again, back over here to Photoshop, make sure that you're very intentional when it comes to naming the file extension what you wanted to do. And I would also recommend that in regards to making sure that you everything that you do, even if you have something that you write and you post online or a video that you create, I always make sure that my extension has a unique name in regards to what I'm trying to do there. So I can come over here and I'm gonna save this one. I'm gonna do this one more example with you guys, and I'm gonna say blue underscore split underscore dress. And this right here is going to, that's going to be the file extension, and my client's going to take this image right here as is, and she's going to upload it right to her website, and hopefully you guys will find her on the web, you know. So thanks for watching, just another quick tutorial when it comes to your web design, to be very intentional. Talk to you later. Goodbye.